Polio is a viral disease that until the 80s crippled an estimated 350,000 children every year. The virus enters the body through the mouth and multiplies in the intestines. It can reach the central nervous system where it replicates and destroys the nerve cells that control the muscles, causing paralysis and even death. Thanks to a global effort to tackle polio through vaccination, in 2012, fewer than 250 children were paralyzed, but the disease remains endemic in three countries. Poor infrastructure and political instability may prevent the administration of vaccines. A polio vaccination ban issued in Pakistan in 2012 has increased the risk of outbreaks, as 900,000 people are now migrating from the north of the country after a recent escalation in the conflict with the Taliban, and the virus may travel with them. Researchers are working to implement the WHO Global Polio Eradication Initiative, a program that should allow the world to get rid of polio forever by 2018.
The general principles of vaccination are in fact based on using the capacity of an organism to mount an immune response against a foreign body which is introduced deliberately in the organism. In the field of polio vaccination, we have at our disposal two vaccines. The first one is the oral polio virus vaccine, which is a mixture of live attenuated vaccines, which are orally delivered and which are inducing an infection of the subject, and therefore this subject is able to develop an immune response against polio virus. The second type of vaccine, IPV, is a mixture of killed polioviruses which are delivered by intramuscular injection and which are able to induce also an immune response in the subjects who are vaccinated.
In the past few decades, the OPV vaccine has been widespread because it's easier to produce and administer, just two drops in the mouth. It can be done by volunteers instead of doctors, but IPV is a safer option.
IPV by definition is a much safer product compared to OPV because it's made on killed organism and therefore is unable to induce a disease, whereas OPV, as it is made with a live organism, is by definition inducing an infection in the vaccine.
The Mérieux campus in Lyon, France, is the world's biggest center for the production of vaccines.
The process for vaccine production is divided into four major steps. The first one is the bulk production. We are producing the vaccines itself. The second part is what we call the formulation. It's a mixing between this vaccine and other components, raw material. The third step is the filling, either in syringes or in vials. And the fourth step is inspection, visual inspection, followed by packaging, final packaging. So the whole process is long. It's about 2 years from the start to the end.
Polio vaccine production is now an established technology, and the Global Polio Eradication Initiative aims to make vaccines even cheaper for developing countries, down to $1 per dose. But challenges remain.
We have at our disposal today tools which are totally effective to control poliomyelitis and poliovirus circulation. In the countries where polioviruses are still circulating, as of today, Nigeria, Pakistan, Afghanistan, the issues is coming from the way how the vaccines are used rather than on the type of vaccine used. But again, with the two vaccines which are currently at our disposal, we have the tools to finish the job and to eradicate poliovirus circulation.